I'm here at the Renegade Homestead where I built this composting outhouse, and I wanted to show it to people to give you an idea of how nice an outhouse can actually be. So I'm going to start here and show you a few things outside before I show you the inside. The first is that we've got a solar panel there that actually charges a small solar light that is motion activated inside, which I'll show you when I get to the inside portion. We've got these vents. These are crawl space vents that you can get commercially locally at a Lowe's or Home Depot. They actually open and close based on the temperature. So if it is 70 degrees, above 70 degrees inside the outhouse, those open up to allow air to flow, colder air to flow from the bottom up to the top and keep the area nice and cool inside. If it gets below 70 degrees, they close up so you don't have cold drafts coming through. The building itself was built on these concrete footings, and the reason is that way I was able to build it in such a way that if we ever wanted to, we could take a tractor with forks on it, get underneath, pick it up, and move it to anywhere else on the property. And the inside was just 4x4s and 2x4s, so it was a pretty simple simple structure. The roof, we're collecting the rainwater off of it into this gutter and down the downspout. And then I have a diverter here that diverts water into this barrel. This is the overflow. We actually wanted to make sure that the barrel doesn't fill all the way, because a 55-gallon barrel with 8 pounds per gallon of water in it is actually going to weigh over 400 pounds. And I didn't want that much weight cantilevered off the back of the building. So we're keeping the water level right around there. And then we have a spigot that you just turn on and off as needed. This is just a simple hand washing station so that when people use the facilities, they have a place to wash their hands when they're done. So I think that kind of covers the outside. I put a simple screen door handle on so it latches and stays closed so the wind can't blow it open. But then when you want to open it, it's easy. It also has a little lock in here, so when you're inside, you can actually lock it and people can't get in, which is super handy. This is the solar light I was mentioning. It's got a little motion sensor in the middle there, so it's only on when people are in here, meaning most of the time it's just sitting there charging, and should have plenty of electricity to run as long as it's needed. You can see the construction in here is just 4x4s on the outside corners, and then 2x4s for the edge that we can attach this siding board to. Here's the composting toilet, which is just a 5-gallon bucket, and we put a compostable bag over the top of it. I'll show you here. And this slides in and out, so that compostable bag just goes over the top. You take a rubber band and seal it over there. That way, when you come in to empty it, when it's done, you can just fold this over, pull the whole bag out, close it on the top, and never have to touch anything. And I put slots in there so that when you push that back in, it can only sit in the exact spot that it needs to be properly oriented around the toilet. And then when you're done using it, you just throw in some sawdust or small shavings, and there's no smell. So that's pretty much it. That should cover the entirety of this build. If you have any questions, throw those in the comments. I'd love to answer any questions you have on it. But so far, it's working out really well, and I think it's really a very pleasant outhouse to use.